Rockets originated in China, and in modern times, the technology was exclusively appropriated by the West. Then how does ISRO came into the picture? Setting new world records with launch of 104 satellites, becoming first country to reach the Mars in single attempt, and debunking the prophecies of the West who deemed India, reeling under poverty, incompetent for space race, this journey was full of ups and downs. Vikram Sarabhai, under whose stewardship India dreamt of invading the outer space, was a prodigy among scientists. When countries were signing treaties for non-militaristic use of space technology, he perceived it as blessing in disguise for solving the problems of humankind. USSR Sputnik in 1957 triggered a space race in tandem with proliferation of nuclear weapons under heightened Cold War. US President John F. Kennedy announced in 1960 manned lunar mission, which was later accomplished in 1969. For Americans, a single step for a man was giant leap for mankind. For Indians too, the year marked a giant leap in space exploration and research with establishment of ISRO. ISRO's first research laboratory was set up in Tumba, Kerala, in a church, which was voluntarily donated by a Christian community. The first sounding rocket was carried on bicycle. Later in 1975, India's first indigenous satellite was launched by USSR. Interestingly, the country in South Asia which had head start in space exploration was Pakistan. Thanks to Abdus Salam, the first Muslim Nobel laureate in science, but Subarco, their space agency, had a tragic fall and now moribund. In 2014, when ISRO's Mars Orbiter mission, aka MOM, met an astounding success. In follow-up, New York Times published a disparaging cartoon which was intended to undermine the efforts of Indian scientists. In contrast to NASA's mammoth spending of $671 million, MOM spent a frugal sum of $74 million. There were prompt reactions, questioning the moral legitimacy of Indian state in going for space voyages. When her children perished due to malnourishment, in such circumstances, how could a country afford space explorations? When Vikram Sarabhai faced the same question, he reacted. It is not a question a developing country could afford to go for space technology, but whether it could afford not to. Today, India has got parvenu status in elite space group. Countries grudgingly accepted success. The initial accomplishment of ISRO were nurtured by scientists like Sarabhai, Satish Dhawan, and APJ Abdul Kalam. While it was his work at DRDO that brought him laurels and earned him name Missile Man. Kalam belonged more to ISRO, where he spent 20 years. He made significant contribution as project director for developing SLV-3, which successfully injected satellite Rohini in near orbit in 1980. After every success of ISRO, it has become convention. Jubilant faces of women scientists are spread across media coverages. Women scientists are indispensable at ISRO, numbering 20% of entire brains at work. Despite receiving a shoestring budget, ISRO's commercial arm, Antariksh, has brought large monetary fortunes. Forex revenue for Antariksh rose 205% in 2015. ISRO's rock-bottom prices are drawing foreign clients. Private space programmers such as Ariane Space and SpaceX are yet to match its cost-effectiveness. While a satellite launch on Ariane Space cost $100 million, whereas on SpaceX it cost $60 million. In contrast, ISRO charges $3 million per satellite. Apart from lucrative business, ISRO also directly or indirectly addresses umpteen number of problems faced by common Indians. Remote sensing data provided by ISRO indicates the onset and strength of monsoons, otherwise known as the real finance minister of India. Being a littoral country, coastal India is highly vulnerable to cyclones and seasonal storms, and in recent years, these are worsened, thanks to climate change. Despite an increase in frequency of cyclones, the loss of life remains in single digit. This has been made possible by ingenious and accurate predictions by meteorologists relying on the data provided by ISRO. ISRO's rise has been meteoric, and hopefully it will continue soaring high. With many missions lined up from interplanetary missions to Jupiter and Venus to having its own space station.